Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. You have a fair coin that shows heads 50% of the time and tails 50% of the time. You and a friend play a coin flipping game. Can you create a rule classifying the coin flips so that you win with probability exactly equal to P and your friend wins with probability exactly equal to 1 minus P? The probability can be any rational or irrational number between 0 and 1. The game has to end in a finite number of coin flips with probability 1. Can you figure it out? You can also try this extension to the problem. Now you have a coin that shows heads with probability Q between 0 and 1. But unfortunately, the value Q is unknown to you. In other words, you have a biased coin, but you don't know the bias. Can you now figure out a game where you win with probability P? The value of P is known to you. The same restrictions apply. The game has to end in a finite number of coin flips with probability 1. Can you figure out these problems? Give them a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. Let's get started with some examples. Imagine you wanted to win a game with probability 3/4. One way to do this is you could imagine flipping the coin 2 times. This generates 4 equally likely sequences of coin tosses. We can classify 3 of those sequences as a win for you, and 1 of those sequences as a loss for you. This will be a game in which you win 3/4 of the time. Now imagine instead you wanted to win a game with probability 1/3. We can slightly modify this procedure. We have 4 coin tosses. What we do is we classify 1 of them as a win, 2 of them as a loss, and we say the third sequence, 2 tails in a row, we can just classify that as disregard these 2 tosses and start all over. So flip 2 times again, and we again have the same rules on what you do with the coin tosses. You will win this game with probability 1/3. We can generalize this procedure. Imagine you wanted to win a game with probability X over Y. You would need to flip the coin just enough times so that you get to a value that's more than Y. We can then classify X of the sequences as a win. We can classify Y minus X of the sequences as a loss. And then we can classify the rest of the sequences as starting over. Just disregard them and start over according to the same rules. You'll win this game with the probability of X over Y. But what if you wanted to win a game with probability 1 divided by pi? Now, since 1 over pi is irrational, we cannot write it exactly as X over Y for integers X and Y. So this procedure is not going to be easily modified to figure out things where we need an irrational probability. So we're going to use a different procedure. The solution is to use binary numbers. So we'll write the probability P in terms of its binary expansion. So this will be a sequence of fractions that are powers of 2. This can be written as 0.b1, b2, b3, and so on. So just like we write decimal numbers, these are going to be fractional numbers that are in binary. Each of these fractional numbers, b1, b2, these represent powers of 1/2. So how is this going to be useful for us? I'll give some examples of binary numbers. So we have the fraction 1/2. This can be written as 1/2 plus 0 over 2 to the power of 2 plus 0 over 2 to the power of 3 and so on. So in binary form, this will be 0.1 and then there will be zeros after that. The number 1/3 will be written as 0.0101 repeating. It'll be 0101 and so on. 1 over pi also will have a binary expansion. This will go on forever, but there is a binary expansion to this number. So how is this going to help us? We have the probability in its binary form. Here's the game we're going to define. Flip a coin until it lands on heads for the first time. Let's say that's toss number N. The rule of the game is that if B sub N equals 1, you win the game. If B sub N equals 0, then you lose the game. So for example, let's say the probability is 1/3. This will be 0, 1, 0, 1, and so on. You win if the first time the coin shows heads is on an even number toss, 2, 4, 6, etc., and you lose the game otherwise. So how come this game has a probability of 1/3 of you winning the game? Let's prove that it always has a probability of P. The probability you win the game is the probability that the first heads shows on toss number K times the value of the binary digit in the value K. So the probability that you get the first heads showing on toss K is 1 over 2 to the power of K. And the probability that the binary digit is equal to 1 in that spot is exactly the binary digit, because the binary digit in spot K is either going to be 0 or 1. What we have is we have come up with exactly the binary representation of P. Therefore, the probability you win this game is exactly equal to P. So there's another way you can use binary numbers to create a game in which you win with probability P. We start out with our binary representation of P. We now do something slightly different. For each flip of the coin, we record a 1 if we flipped a heads, and we record a 0 if we flipped tails. We are going to keep flipping the coin as long as flip K equals the binary digit on K. Once we get to a point where the flip differs, say that's toss N, we're going to define that you win the game if your flip was tails, and you're going to lose the game if the flip was heads. So why does this procedure work? Let's go through the example where P is equal to 1/3. We have our binary representation. So here's how the game would work. Let's imagine we flip tails, heads, heads. The first two digits, 0, 1, are the same as the 0, 1 in 1/3, but that third value in 1/3 is equal to 0, and we flipped a heads on our last one, which was different. So we're going to stop flipping after this third flip, and the last flip we had was a heads. So we differed and it was a heads, so we're going to define this as a loss. If instead we flipped tails, tails, that would mean our second toss was different from the binary expansion of 1/3. And in this case, the last flip differed as a tails. So in this case, we would win the game. So this may sound like a strange procedure, but there's an intuitive way to see why it works. Intuitively, the coin flips will define a random number Z that's between 0 and 1. If this number Z that we get to by flipping ends up being less than P, we are winning the game. And if it's more than P, we lose the game. So basically, we're creating with our coin flips a random number between 0 and 1. And if this number ends up being in the interval 0 to P, we're going to win. So we win this game with probability P. Here's a graphical way to see what's going on in this game. We start out with our interval 0, 1. Let's suppose we have a probability of P of 1/3. So we're saying the winning interval is numbers that end up between 0 and 1/3. Now the first toss of our coin, suppose it's a heads. So we know that our number Z is going to start out with 0.1. Well, A number that starts out 0.1 is going to define something between 1/2 and 1. It's going to at least be 1/2 because 0.1 means we're adding 1/2 to whatever remains. So if our first toss is a heads, we're going to end up in something that's larger than 1/3, and there's no way that we could end up in the interval between 0 and 1/3. So our number differs in the very first spot, and it differs to be larger, so we're going to lose the game for sure. Let's suppose we continue where the first toss was a tails. This instead would define a number between 0 and 1/2. We can never get a number larger than 1/2 because the first spot in our expansion of z is equal to 0.0. So in order to see where z ends up, we're going to have to flip again. So let's say at this point we flip tails. So we have 0.00. So now we're going to define an interval that's actually between 0 and 1/4. Z has to be less than 1/4 from its form. Furthermore, we have a number z where that second digit 0, 0, that's differing from the second digit of p. But in this case, the differing digit is a tails. So we know that we are going to win this game for sure. To give one more example, suppose that we had tosses of tails, heads, heads. Now the first time we differed was the third toss. However, we differed by being a heads, so we actually ended up in an interval that's larger than 1/3. So we're going to lose this game for sure. So now let's tackle the extension. We have a biased coin that shows with probability, heads with probability Q. How can we solve the game now? What we're going to do is we're going to make a fair toss from the biased coin. We're going to flip the biased coin 2 times. This creates 4 possible different tosses. We don't know the probability of each of these tosses, but we're going to classify them as follows. We're going to say if you toss 2 heads or 2 tails, just disregard that outcome and start over. If, however, you tossed heads-tails, classify that as a heads, and if you tossed tails-heads, classify that as a tails. So while we don't know the exact probability of these outcomes, we can calculate their theoretical probability because we know the coin shows heads with probability Q. So if we wanted, so the probability of heads will be tossing a heads followed by a tails. So this will be Q times 1 minus Q. The probability of tossing a tails will be the probability of tossing T followed by H. So this will be 1 minus Q times Q. What you'll notice here is that the probability of HT is exactly equal to the probability of TH. In other words, we have a game which ends with heads or tails exactly 50% of the time for each of those 2 cases. The probability of heads is equal to the probability of tails. In other words, we have made a fair coin out of a biased coin. So now the problem reduces to what do we do if we have a fair coin and we need to win the game with probability P? Well, we've just solved that problem. We can use one of the binary number procedures that have just been described, and we can get to a game which we win with probability P. So it's an absolutely stunning result. We can simulate any probability P that we want, rational or irrational, from a coin, and it can be a biased coin where we don't even know the bias. Did you figure out this problem? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions. You can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalker. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.